Hello friends, welcome to my channel. In this video I'm going to show you how to make a simple and tasty mutton chukka. Recently I have been on a trip to India and I have taken videos of few recipes there which I'll be sharing it with you one after the other. So let's get started. For this I have taken 250 grams of goat meat. I washed it a couple of times and add them into the pressure cooker. Add little water and to this add 1/2 teaspoon of salt. We are not going to add the entire salt that is required for this recipe, just add 1/2 of it. Mix well and close the pressure cooker, and I'm going to cook this at medium flame for 3 whistles because the meat I'm using is very tender. So adjust the cooking time according to the tenderness of the meat. It's been cooked for 3 whistles. The pressure has been released. Let's open it and have a look. At this stage, always make sure the mutton is cooked to soft. If not, close the pressure cooker and cook for a few more minutes and make sure it's cooked till soft. In a pan, I have heated up 1.5 tablespoons of oil. When the oil is hot, add a small piece of cinnamon, and I have chopped 7 to 8 shallots lengthwise. And to this, I'm going to add little curry leaves and 3 crushed garlic. Instead of adding garlic paste, try adding crushed garlic. It gives a nice flavor. Saute them well. The raw smell of garlic and onion has gone. Now I'm adding 1/2 teaspoon of turmeric powder. And to this I'm going to add 1.5 teaspoon of red chili powder. Based on your required spice level, you can always adjust the quantity of red chili powder. Give it a mix and let it cook till the raw smell goes off. Next, I'm going to add the salt. Make sure you add little less salt because we have already added salt while cooking the mutton. It's been well cooked now. Time to add the mutton along with its stock. Mix well, and it has to be cooked in medium flame till all the water gets evaporated and it becomes like a thick curry. Give it a mix now and then. It's been half cooked. The water level has reduced a bit and now it's been almost dried up. But still you have to cook it till the oil oozes out from this curry. Only then it tastes good. At this stage, always make sure you keep mixing it very frequently so that it doesn't get burnt at the bottom. It's been completely done. You can see some oil oozing out and the aroma will be fantastic. At this stage, you can turn off the heat and you can transfer this mutton chukka to a plate. In the leftover masala that is stuck to the pan, add little steamed rice and mix well. Do give this a try. Don't ever miss it because it really tastes good with the flavor of mutton in it. Whenever I make mutton chukka, I always make sure I do this. And that's all. Our tasty and simple mutton chukka is now ready. Do try this recipe at home and post your comments. If you like this video and if you wish to watch more such interesting recipes, subscribe to this channel. Thanks for watching.